Hello, welcome back to Fashion Arts Camp. Today we're going to have a lot of fun, and I want you to go into your kit and get this tie-dye set. And what's super cool about this tie-dye is that it comes in some spray bottles. It's all ready to go, and it has so many beautiful colors. So let's get all our spray bottles out of our box and line them up. Now, you probably want to have a setup on your table of some newspaper, something, so when you start spraying these things, it doesn't mess up your whole area. And you probably shouldn't be wearing a white shirt like I am, but you know what? I'm okay with that. So I'm going to go ahead and lay down some paper towel right on my table. So I know that wherever I'm going to be spraying, it's going to get on my paper towel and not on my table. And today we are going to be tie-dyeing a hat. Now, part of tie-dyeing that's really cool is that you can use rubber bands to gather the material, and you can put these rubber bands all over your hat, and you're going to scrunch it up. So in your bag, you got a bag full of rubber bands. So let's take a couple out. Okay. And now your hat could have been washed already, and that's going to help all your dye stay on. But the other thing to remember, just like all of our projects, you're going to want to heat set this at the end. And after it's heat set, that means these colors are going to stay real nice and bright and pretty, even if it gets wet and goes into the wash. Okay, so in order to gather fabric, what you're going to do is just kind of take an area and squinch it up. And you can have a parent help you with this, because this part can be a little tricky. Yep, see, I even broke a rubber band. So just do the best you can to get some rubber bands on there so that we can have a little bit of a tie-dye pattern. And the reason it makes a pattern is because wherever the rubber band is touching is going to stay white. My rubber bands keep snapping. So with me snapping the rubber bands, it does help you keep in mind that you want to maybe not get them as tightly as I was doing, so we don't keep snapping them. But even if you decide not to use rubber bands, that's okay too, because the colors, when you spray them, are so pretty. So you can decide to put rubber bands on your hat or not. I think I'll just put a few on. And after I'm done spraying, when I let it dry for a little while, later, after it's dry, I can take these rubber bands off, and wherever they were is going to leave a pattern that's white, just like the hat is. It seems to be easier to do from the back, so go ahead and put those rubber bands towards the back of the hat. So I'm going to put down 3, just because it's kind of fun to see those patterns. But later on, we're also going to be doing tie-dye t-shirts, and it'll be a lot easier to spray those. Okay, so now we've got our hat. Don't worry too much about the plastic. We can dry that later. Let's go ahead and pick some of these colors. Let's see, what do we have here? We have this beautiful turquoise. So I am going to go close to my hat, and I'm just gonna give it a few sprays. Okay, I wanna keep it close because I wanna keep my spray paint on top of my surface, like my paper towel. So wherever I want to add a color, I just go nice and close, and I give it a few squirts. And I'm going to go ahead and look and think, what colors do I like together? I don't have to use all the colors. Maybe I just want it to be blues and pinks and reds. You know, those are the kind of decisions you can make. Even though you have a whole set, doesn't mean you have to use all the colors. And look, when I spray, it's actually, if I put one color down, it starts to cover. So let's see what happens if we layer these colors. So far, oh, here's a pretty one, this purple. And I want to get in there anywhere where I put the rubber band. It's going to have little folds. So I want to be sure that I can get near where those folds are. But just in case you do it and you're not able to get in where those folds are, that's no big deal, because after you take the rubber bands off, you'll be able to spray over those areas again. Okay? So we're just having fun spraying the colors, trying to get in there. And you want to turn it around. Now, it's up to you. You can spray the inside of the hat right here on the bill. So I haven't used any orange or yellow. So that might be a fun place to use some of that color. So I put some orange down, and let's see, I'm gonna add some yellow there. Now remember, this can get messy. So just make sure you stay right close to your object and you stay right on top of your paper, okay? So that way you can keep the mess contained. And if when you're turning it, you see an area that you could spray maybe a little more, then go ahead and spray a little more. Now, with the tie-dye, you see it got a little on the plastic? Well, that's fine. I can just sponge that off later. No big deal. I've got my hat and I've sprayed orange on the other side as a little unexpected surprise. And I'm letting it dry a little. Now, even if you get this on your hands, that's okay. It'll come off with soap and water. It's all non-toxic. Now let's go ahead. Now look here. See how I had that fold and it's got some white there? I'm going to go ahead and just open that fold a little and spray that color right there in that fold. Okay. Now, I'm going to look around. Do I have other folds? Well, yes, I do. I have a few. So, I'm just going to look around. I'm not worried. I know I have to wash my hands anyway. So, no biggie. And now I'm going to want to let it dry a little bit. But after it's dry, I can take out my rubber bands. Now, I want you to wait for it to dry, but since I'm really excited to show you how it looks, I'm going to take my rubber bands out a little early. So just carefully pull my rubber bands off, and let's see what we get. Okay, hang on. Here we go. Now, it's always better to actually wait for it to dry, but this could give you a little preview of how cool it's gonna look. Okay, and remember, when you're done, if you want, you could glue a patch on, you can glue some jewels all over to make it extra sparkly and wonderful. So here is some of those patterns that are made with the rubber band. See that? And here on this side. But if you feel like there's too much white, like I said, no worries. Go ahead and add some more spray in those spots and have fun with the colors. They mix up really pretty, and then go ahead and let it dry, okay? After it's dry, you can go ahead and heat set it again, just like all of our projects, 3 to 5 minutes with the blow dryer. And then you've got this super cool hat. So I hope you enjoyed making it. And go ahead and clean up your area, wash your hands with soap and water, put your caps back on all your paints so that they're good for next time. And I will see you again for another fashion arts class. Thanks again for coming, and I'll see you next time. Bye.